It's day two here at RILA 2019 in Denver, Colorado. We started at 75 and sunny on Sunday, and today it's 45 with a chance of snow. But lucky for us, all the action happens inside. What were your thoughts on this morning's session?
I was very good. Very happy to have our CMO, Frank Hamlin, here from GameStop. Really to talk a little bit about some of the challenges that GameStop's going through in the industry right now with digital disintermediation, really focusing on our experience in our stores and our customer and what that means for our business, something we've been working a lot on the last year or so.
So you're talking in a session later today. Can you give us an idea of what you're going to be talking about?
Yes, I'm excited. I'm going to share a little bit about my journey with AutoZone and how over the past 24 years, I have had many different career paths. And how that kind of plays into my diversity and inclusion story, since I had many great mentors that were really open to seeing the possibility of me along the way.
Oren, you're a first timer here at RILA. Tell me about your experience so far.
So far, it's been great. I mean, very busy, lots of vendors, lots of great technology, networking with a lot of great people here.
I think the most insightful thing has been visiting with other retailers to see where their areas of opportunity are and then maybe how they've solved that, and then the collaboration amongst the different retailers.
Chris, why is it important to keep coming back to RILA every year?
Very important to be engaged with our clients. Whenever we have new products, new services, this gives us a chance to kind of demo that.
It's critical to our entire strategy to be well connected with the LP community and not just say we're going to sell you a product, but really to understand what their problems are. And RILA is a tremendous organization for us to see what retailers are really looking for.
It's so great to see the people that we've been involved with for over the years. I've been in the industry for over 25 years. And there's no better place to network than at RILA.
Overall, I had a great experience. Had a lot of my team here from Lowe's attended with me. I really, really enjoyed our tech this year. So I think they displayed a lot of great vendors, a lot of good solutions, a lot of good innovation. But I really saw how that translated into the expo as well. So I have four vendors that we partnered with or that we're going to partner with going forward for different solutions. They're not necessarily all new vendors, but they have new innovative ways that they're approaching the business and updated their technology to solve for some pretty big problems that we're experiencing right now in hardlines retail.
Laura, what was the session that you attended that really stuck out to you today?
It had to do with misdemeanors and just circling the wagon and how we can educate students, the high school students, basically on preventing them from shoplifting. And really doing our due diligence as a retailer for the community and maybe working with our community relations group at our corporate office to try and integrate that into some high school education.
Any insight into what's going to happen next year?
So as I shared in my opening comments, we're inviting non-RILA member companies to participate in the steering committee for the first time ever. So anytime you change the dynamic of a group, you're going to change and influence the output. And so I'm super excited about what 2020 has in store for us. So we'll be back in Dallas.
Another successful RILA has come to an end. Thanks so much for keeping your eye on LP. We'll see you next year in Dallas.